May our prayer come before you, O Lord, as the incense, and the lifting up of our hands as the evening sacrifice.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Psalm 36.
Deep is a voice of rebellion, deep in the heart of the wicked. There is no fear of God before his eyes.
He flatters himself in his own words, that his hateful sin will not be found.
The words of his mouth are wicked and deceitful. He has left off acting wisely and doing good.
He thinks of wickedness upon his bed and has set himself in no good way. He does not abhor that which is evil.
Your love, O Lord, reaches to the heavens, and your faithfulness to the clouds.
Your righteousness is like the strong mountains, your justice like the great deep. You save both man and beast, O Lord.
How priceless is your love, O God. Your people take refuge under the shadow of your wings.
They feast upon the abundance of your heart. You give them drink from the river of your delights.
For with you is the well of life, and in your light we see light.
Continue your loving kindness to those who know you, and your favor to those who are true of God.
Let not the foot of the proud come near me, nor the hand of the wicked push me aside.
See how they are fallen, those who work wickedness. They are cast down and shall not be able to arise.
Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
First Book of the Kings, the 8th chapter, beginning at the 65th verse. Solomon held a festival at this time, and all Israel with him, a great assembly. People from Lebo Hamath to the Wadi Nocket, before the Lord our God 7 days. On the 8th day he sent the people away, and they blessed the king and went to their tents, joyful and in good spirits, because of all the goodness that the Lord had shown to his servant David and to his people Israel. When Solomon had finished building the house of the Lord and the king's house, and all that Solomon had desired to build, the Lord appeared to Solomon a second time, as he had appeared to him at Gibeon. The Lord said to him, I have heard your prayer and your plea, which you have made before me. I have consecrated this house that you have built, and put my name there forever. My eyes and my heart will be there for all time. As for you, if you will walk before me as David your father walked, with integrity of heart and uprightness, doing according to all that I have commanded you, and keeping my statutes and my ordinances, then I will establish your royal throne over Israel forever, as I promised your father David, saying, there shall not fail you a successor on the throne of Israel. If you turn aside from following me, you or your children, and do not keep my commandments and my statutes that I have set before you, but go and serve other gods and worship them, then I will cut off Israel from the land that I have given, and the house that I have consecrated for my name I will cast out of my sight. And Israel will become a proverb and a taunt among all peoples. This house will become a heap of ruins. Everyone passing by it will be astonished and will hiss, and they will say, "Why has the Lord done such a thing to this land and to this house?" And then they will say, "Because they have forsaken the Lord their God, who brought their ancestors out of the land of Egypt, and embraced other gods, worshipping them and serving them. Therefore, the Lord has brought this disaster upon them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Exultet, spiritus meus, in Domino Deo, salutari meo. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his glorious servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him. In every generation, he has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy. The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the years, now and will be forever. Amen. Exultet spiritus meus in Domino Deo, salutari meo.
The Acts of the Apostles, the 12th chapter, beginning at the first verse. About that time, King Herod laid violent hands upon some who belonged to the church. He had James, the brother of John, killed with a sword. After he saw that it pleased the Jews, he proceeded to arrest Peter also. This was during the festival of unleavened bread. When he had seized him, he put him in prison and handed him over to four squads of soldiers to guard him, intending to bring him out to the people after the Passover. While Peter was in prison, the church prayed fervently to God for him. The very night before Herod was going to bring him out, Peter, bound with two chains, was sleeping between two soldiers, while guards in front of the door were keeping watch over the prison. Suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared, and a light shone in the cell. He tapped Peter on the side and woke him, saying, "Get up quickly," and the chains fell off his wrists. The angel said to him, "Fasten your belt and put on your sandals." He did so. Then he said to him, "Wrap your cloak around you and follow me." Peter went out and followed him. He did not realize that what was happening with the angel's help was real. He thought he was seeing a vision. After they had passed the first and second guard, they came before the iron gate leading into the city. It opened for them of its own accord, and they went outside and walked along the lane, when suddenly the angel left him. Then Peter came to himself and said, "Now I am sure that the Lord has sent his angel and rescued me from the hands of Herod and from all that the Jewish people were expecting." As soon as he realized this, he went to the house of Mary, the mother of John, whose other name was Mark, where many had gathered and were praying. When he knocked on the outer gate, a maid named Rhoda came to answer. On recognizing Peter's voice, she was so overjoyed that instead of opening the gate, she ran in and announced that Peter was standing at the gate. They said to her, "You are out of your mind." But she insisted that it was so. They said, "It is his angel." Meanwhile, Peter continued knocking. And when they opened the gate, they saw him and were amazed. He motioned to them with his hand to be silent and described to them how the Lord had brought him out of prison. And he added, Tell this to James and to the believers. Then he left and went to another place. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Nunc dimittis servum tuum, Domine, secundum verbum tuum in pace, quia videront oculi mei, salutare tuum, quod parasi, ante faciem omnium populorum, lumina revelationem gentium, et gloria credis tuae Israel. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
I believe in
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended
to the dead.
On the third day he rose again.
He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body,
and the life everlasting.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care,
and guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon us,
your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten,
nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God,
and sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Lord of all power and might, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your name, increase in us true religion, nourish us with all goodness, and bring forth in us the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works, give to us your servants that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour.
Amen.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
O God and Father, whom the whole heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship you, all nations obey you, all tongues confess and bless you, and men and women everywhere love you and serve you in peace. Through you, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us bless them.
Thanks be to God.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing, power of the Holy Spirit.